Hello friends, this is Yusuf here. Today we are going to see how to create our first REST-based web service using AS400. If you remember from our last video, we could have used this QTMH write-out procedure, and using that we have created or we have learned how to send the response back to browser. So we are going to use the same concept, but instead of the HTML content, we are going to pass the XML content. So as like before, I would like to show the output first, then we'll go and see how to do that. Okay, so here I have a database called employee PF, okay, and it is having few details of the employee like ID, name, position, and then grade, and etc. So we are going to create web service something like this. So if you pass the employee ID as a parameter, it should tell us whether it's found, or if it is found, it has to tell us the details. So that's what we are going to try. Suppose if you pass a wrong parameter like a character, then you should say it's an invalid URL. So take for example, if the employee ID 555 belongs to the name David, so we go here and we give 555, and then we receive the response. So let's quickly see how to do this. Okay, first let's understand what's happening. So when we pass this as our URL, first of all we need to recognize the ID which is passed or the number which is passed. So apparently we need to first write the code to extract this number from this URL. If you remember our previous script alias match configuration in HTTP config file, you could have mentioned like if anything comes with mycga and then this particular thing, okay, will be matched with this program name under library. But now we need to have the extra parameter, so we need to change this a little bit. Okay, so now what we have done, we are going to create a new script alias match which is going to match the my web service URL, and whatever comes next is going to be a program name, but also we include a slash dot star in your match, which means that the browser will expect the exact match of this URL, which means we have to give this slash some value. If not, it will show the invalid URL error. Okay, I just opened the HTTP config file, and then I have added the script alias which we have just seen. So it's going to match the web service my web service and slash, and then whatever comes is the program name, and then whatever comes is going to be our parameter. Okay, before we move further, I want to give a simple tip. You remember last time, right, we have compiled as a module and then created as a program because we are using AS400 service program inside. So now if you want to do that in a single step, what we need to do, we need to create a binding directory. In this case, I have just created a binding directory called test. So display binding directory test. So this will be included the service program which we are going to use. So we need to create the binding directory, and then we need to add the binding directory with this particular service program. So once you are done that, right, please include this header specification, default activation group no, activation group new, and then your binding directory. By doing this, you don't need to compile like as a module and then as a program. Instead, you can just take a 14 and then you can compile it. Okay, now let's understand how to get this particular variable. Okay, so actually this, since is a URL, right, so we can use a get environment procedure, inbuilt procedure, which will retrieve this particular whatever the URL we pass, right, we can get it using get environment procedure. Okay, now I'm quickly going to create the program get employee, and then I'm going to see the result. Okay, I just created a program, and then as I said earlier, I have included the binding directory, and this is our standard write to web procedure based on this particular inbuilt API. And then I just quickly done a small check whether it's working or not. So I'm just displaying HTML content into the browser, and I'm just going to check whether it's working. So I'm going to compile it, and once it compiled, I'm going to run the URL in the browser. So I'm getting the response. So it means our program is working, and we are able to get this data into the browser. Now let's get this URL and display it how it comes inside the program. Okay, so to get the variable, right, so I have just included this procedure get environment based on the inbuilt procedure get env, and this is available in qc2le binding directory, so we can just include that also in this in the header specification. And then if you come down, I have just added this line. So here, right, I'm going to get the URL using the request URI environment variable, and this will come to the data, and then we are printing it in the browser. Let's see the output. Okay, now we are going to execute the same URL. Now you can see, right, so the URL is actually coming inside the program. So now we can use this to parse this value, and then we can do our logic. Without wasting much time, I'm just going to do the remaining portion of the code. Okay, I have completed the code, so I'll walk you through. So what we have done is we have included our employee pf and then key list, and then we have changed the content type to XML because it's going to be XML. And then we are parsing the, we are getting the URL using the request URI method, and then we are filtering out based on our parameter get emp, and then whatever comes next we are treating that as a employee ID. And then we are just checking whether it's a character or numeric, and if it is a character field, something like that, so we are displaying invalid URI. And if it's a proper value, then we are coming next, and we are building the XML. So here is the XML portion. So we are going to create XML called starting with employee detail, and then we are going to chain with that particular value, and then we are getting the details. If suppose the value is not available, then we are printing employee not found, and finally we are writing the data into the browser. So here you can see, right, so it's not necessary that we need to concatenate all the data into the variable and finally write it to browser. We can do it as a chunk of data. So we can see we are doing it in ad hoc basis. Okay, and finally when you give a return, it will return all the data into the browser. So let's quickly check it's working or not. Okay, I'm going to compile it. Okay, and then I'm going to execute the same URL, but I can see employee not found because the one is passed inside the program but it's not found. So if I give 111, I should get the value. Just I have missed one point, like if you have changed the configuration file, which is the http.conf, then you need to restart your server using this command. So I hope I covered it. You would have got some idea how to do it, but it's not a good way, like we are concatenating things in the program, those steps. So in my upcoming videos, I'll cover how to optimize this and how to do a how to improve our coding standard to have a best of service. I hope this helps. Thanks for watching.